Hey guys, first of all, I would like to thank you for supporting my channel. It just scored 1000 subscribers and I'm thankful for that. And I hope you will keep supporting my channel and I will give you quality content. In this video, you will learn how to make realistic outdoor lighting using EEVEE inside Blender 2.8. For this tutorial, I've already created the meshes before, so I will just do lighting of it. So what I usually do is use the developer mode to see how HDR lighting is working with the scene. I play with the rotation and background value to see how rotating HDRs affect the lighting. During this, I look up for the mood and colors of the lights, and if I like the lighting of HDRI, then use it for background under the world setting tab. You can also upload your own HDR inside developer mode by clicking the Show Preferences tab, which is located on the right side of the selected HDR. After that, click Install button, which is located under the Look Developer HDR inside the Light tab, and then just select the HDR image to add HDRs to your developer mode. After deciding the HDR, go to the World tab and select Environment Texture under Color node and open the HDR you want for the scene. Now render the scene. To rotate the HDR on Z-axis, you need to plug the mapping node inside vector and then generate texture coordinate to the vector again. In this way, you can rotate the HDR texture. Play with the strength of the HDR to give brightness or darkness. As this serves as the skylight, you will need a value to 1, as it will have a great impact on generating global illumination. But if your HDR is darker, then I recommend to increase the strength as it helps in the diffuse bounce, but keep in mind it will also lighten the shadows. It's up to you what you want for the scene. For this scene, I'm going for a brighter sunny day look. So what I do is, under color management tab, I play with the value of exposure and gamma to get rid of washout look. If the HDR is brighter, then slightly I decrease the value of exposure and then increase or decrease the gamma to get better contrast. You can also change the base contrast to high contrast and use a curve to adjust scene lights. After that, check ambient occlusion. If you change the distance value, you will see it will increase the depth of the scene. Value 10 looks good enough for this scene. If you want to multiply the effect, you can change the factor input value to 2, but make sure it doesn't get too much dark. After that, check screen space reflection, which increases the reflection of your scene. You can increase the precise reflection value to get precise reflection, and play with the max roughness value to get what you want for the scene. After this, you will need irradiance volume to bake diffuse indirect light. So press 7 to get to top orthographic view, and then press Shift A and select irradiance volume under light probe tab. Scale it up by pressing S. You can also watch my previous tutorial on how to create realistic lighting inside EEVEE to get better understanding of how irradiance volume works. Now under the indirect lighting tab, increase the diffuse bounce value to 10. I found that the value from 10 to 15 works best for the diffuse bounce. You can also use it, but it also depends on the mood of your scene, so don't overdo it in every scenario. After that, click Bake Light. After baking, click render button to see how it's looking. You can check the eye icon that is under display tab and increase the value to scale the samples. It helps you to identify how much brightness you have baked to the indirect lighting samples. You can change the strength value of HDRI to 0 to see the baking results. Now what I do is, if I'm happy with the results, I increase the irradiance volume resolution of XYZ to 8, which will be present under Object Data tab. To make a sunny day, we need a sun. Press Shift A and select Sun from the Light tab. After that, position it by pressing G and make sure it's far from the subject. You can also try to match the angle of the sunlight by pressing R and rotating it. It's up to you to match the sun of the HDR, but it can definitely add realism to the scene. You can see here the shadows are clipped off from the end. So to solve it, go to the Object Data tab and increase the clip end value. If you are having issues like light coming from the edges of the wall, you can check contact shadows and increase the distance value and the thickness value to get rid of the light bleeding. Distance value serves as a screen space occluder and thickness value is used for the pixel thickness to detect occlusion. Cascade shadows are for the resolution of the shadow. The higher the number, the more resolution it will have. You can use lower resolution as higher is sometimes costly, depend on how much polys you have in your scene. To get soft shadows, you can get better results by increasing the softness value or just go to the scene tab and under the shadow tab, check the soft shadows and high bit depth.
After checking it, you can change the softness of the shadow by changing the radius of the sunlight. The larger the number, the more it will get soft. But remember, it will also change the size of the specular light of the sun. So it's up to you what you need for the scene. Either you can use the checked soft shadow or use the default softness value. It's up to you. For this tutorial, I have used and played with the default softness value to get end results. Now just change the sun color to slightly yellowish hue. You can also change the intensity of the sun to 2 or 4, which can be used with an overcast lighting, so you can play around it. Now we just need reflection capture. Press Shift A and you can select it from light probe tab. After that, scale it up and press Shift D to duplicate it. Place them near windows and try to position or scale them by barely just touching each other. You can increase the resolution of the captured reflection by changing the value of the cube map size under Indirect Lighting tab. Now just click bake the lighting. As you can see, it has baked the lighting and also has captured the reflection, which is according to the position of the placed cube maps. Now if you want to hide the HDR, you need a sphere, so press Shift A and select sphere from the mesh and scale it up and apply emissive material on it. You can also use color ramp node for the color, and after deciding the color you can change the rotation of the sphere to match the scene. Now if you want to render the results, you need a camera for the scene. So press Shift A again and select camera from the list and position it. Then go to the render tab and hit render. But if you want to have more clean render, you can increase the render samples from the scene tab or just increase the dimension from the output tab. In the end, you can also use bloom and play with the value if you want to give some effects. After that, increase the precision of the screen space reflection to get better reflections. And that's how I managed to create this result. Hope you guys like my tutorial. If you like my tutorial, subscribe and hit the notification bell to get notified whenever I will upload my video. You will get notification about my video. You can also support me on Patreon, where I will be sharing my project files which I have used in my tutorial. Thanks for watching.